Good afternoon. Today we're going to talk about what is an echo filter. As a group, we are in charge of the part of the information of what is an echo filter, how it works, how does it filter water, how does it eliminate microorganisms, what is important in society, etc. All you can imagine about what you can know about an echo filter. First of all, we're going to begin with the story of an echo filter. It all began with the engineer Fernando Mazariegos. He invented the echo filter in Guatemala in 1980. In 2011, it was taken to international level, driven by Philip Wilson, the president of the company Ecofiltro S.A. in Guatemala, who sent a Guatemalan proposal at the contest Access to Markets and Finance Award that was to be held in Finland. The surprise that they got was that this invention won the first place among other competitors around the world. Philip Wilson, the promoter of the echo filter, says that thanks to this award, they will be able to continue giving pure water to poor families, which will allow the control of gastrointestinal diseases in the country. So now we're going to proceed to describe or to define what is an echo filter. So, an echo filter is a device created to meet the needs of drinking water in populations with scarce resources, by which means by implementing a gravity filtration system that can also react to pressure. This filter is based on the basic principle of filtration that makes the earth in its natural form. So, how is it that the earth filters water in its natural form? The purest water tanks regarding to substances and bacteriological controls are found in groundwater. Bio are those waters that we cannot see but are in the ground, so below the ground. By observing the process, it takes this purified water since it is the same as a transition of water through the layers of the earth. And this is all information according to Ecomedit. So, how does an echo filter work? The non-drinking water microorganisms which cause infections and diseases. That's the first thing we need to take into account. Second, a filter is inserted. In this case, it's made of mud, sawdust, and colloidal silver. Why are we talking about this material? Because these are the materials that Ecofiltro S.A. uses to produce or make their echo filters. And as a number three, we know that water filters out a rate of 2 liters per hour, trapping bacteria, and the carbon removes odors and flavors, leaving clean water in healthy families.
So, to starting with the process of filtering the water, first of all, you have to know that the materials that was mentioned before are the materials that are used in the echo filters that Ecofiltro S.A. sells to the consumers. And these are mud, sawdust, and colloidal silver. They are placed like in different layers because they have different proposals. So this is first of all, mud, because it creates micro channels that within its walls can stop bacteria and impurities in the water. The second one is the sawdust, because it becomes cold and it removes turbidity and bad odor or taste in the water. And colloidal silver, it neutralizes bacteria and removes them, acting as a bactericide. So, in addition, there are many variations to these kinds of filters due that they can be made out of different products depending on where you can find them, because it could be a hardware store or even your own house. So, these materials can vary from cotton, fine sand, and long life filtered papers, because they are used to hold back micro elements. So these materials are set in many layers, so the time increases, and the amount of water would be less than other systems, but obviously the effectivity will increase, eliminating most of the bacteria present in the water. So, which organisms does it eliminate? So, as you know, the main problem of dirty water is the content of organisms that can endanger people's health. So, these microorganisms causes diseases like cholera and gastroenteritis, that are like the most dangerous diseases. And the pathogens that causes are Escherichia coli and Salmonella, and other can be the protozoans that stay into the human body and produce cells that weaken the body and damage the organisms. So, ecofilter eliminates bacteria, parasites, viruses, and impurities of the water, like traces of feces.
Okay, my name is Luis Fernando Acosta, and I'm gonna talk to you about the importance of ecofilters in the society. The importance it has in that society is that it's not expensive, so it can be afforded by poor families that do not have access to buy directly purified water. In addition, the process of purifying of water purification has a great importance. It allows water ready to consume by enormous human grouping. This will be very helpful for African countries because, as we all know, Africa is a very, very poor country that don't have the ways to buy water purifiers, and this will help them a lot. So, which are some alternatives to filter water in case of not having an ecofilter? Well, the first is filtration using clothes. I saw in some house that people use in their containers clothes that they put it in the water filter, so that helped them to contain all the dirt and some bacteria. The other is filtration by chlorination. This is very using in areas very apart from the city and in cities too. For example, I think in Trisome they use chlorination for cleaning their water and make them to go to the system of to they're using them to the irrigation system. And the other is the treatment by boiling. That is when you make water boil and kill every bacteria, every pathogen that has the water. And the next one is sand filtration. This is what we are going to explain in our project, that we will use sand for filtrating water. An example of it is Egypt, that they use sand for filtrating water, and they use their clean water for drinking, as we all know.
So, concluding with this section of our project, I have to say that we haven't been able, that we have investigated and we made a different research about the topic because we wanted to cover all the specific points that are important to know in this topic, and we will present this information, and then the other part of the group will make a step-by-step presentation to show you how an ecofilter is made and we're going to make it work to show you the system of purifying the water. So that's it, and thanks.
Hello everyone, today we are going to explain you how to do a NECO filter by an instructional video. Poverty is currently a problem that hinders the lives of people, including the difficulty of access to clean water. At present, 6.6 billion of people around the world have access to clean water sources. On the other hand, 663 billion million is the total number of people without access to clean water around the world. It is for this reason that the realization of an eco filter is important, since this way it can be known the correct way to do it and be able to offer these people an alternative so that they can have a better quality of life, since you cannot live without clean water. Filtration is a phase separation process of a heterogeneous system, which consists of passing a mixture through a porous medium or filter where it is retained from most of the solid components of the mixture. The function of the filter is to remove certain impurities from the stream that runs through it, mainly to purify dirty water easily and quickly. The contamination of water has generated diverse diseases like the cholera that is diagnosed with diarrhea, vomits and strong stomach pains that can arrive until the death, as well as the rusting of pipes of water that cause diseases of kidney because it contains heavy metals. It has been determined that purifying the water will help improve the quality of life in humans, because when the water is purified, pollutants and hazardous residues are eliminated, such as the oxidation of iron pipes, foreign agents such as bacteria, among others. So in this project we will explain you how to make an eco filter, because there is people around the world that doesn't have access to clean water. So with this project we can improve the number of people that can't have access to this clean water with some materials that are in our houses, or we can find in any place. So now I will let you be with my friends, that they will explain you step by step how to make an eco filter with recycled materials. Thank you.
Well, we're going to explain you the materials that we need to make an eco filter. First, we need some bottles. We need a scissor. We need cotton. We need big rocks. We need tiny rocks. We need active carbon. We need gross sand. We need fine sand. Well, the importance of each material is the cotton is to separate each layer of each material. The big rocks, when we put in the eco filter, is to retain the particles that are bigger than the pores created in the rocks. The active carbon is to retain the odor of the water and to retain also organisms. And the gross sand and the fine sand is to retain all the particles that are bigger than the particles of sand. And we have here in a concluded project, and this is how it's going to end, the eco filter. Now my partner is going to explain you more about the process to make an eco filter.
So thanks. I will talk to you and explain you and how to create this filter. It is important to choose really well our materials, and it's important to mention that it's not necessary, that it's not in a specific order to put the materials. It depends how do you want to put it and the materials do you have. These are some of the the most important, the most useful, that is the way we choose to use these materials. To begin, first we have to cut the bottle, like have it here. That is why we use a scissors. We cut it to have the bottle like this. Then our next step is to put a layer of cotton. We put some cotton. It's important to put it really down. I forgot to mention that there are two different levels. The first level of the filter is the level that will help you to filter the big organism, the big particles of the water. And the second level, it will be like the level that will make sure that we have clean water. And this is like the one who will filter the little particles. The first level is this one. Put first cotton, then I put some the small rocks, a layer. It depends how material do you have and how much do you want to put. Then we have to put some the gray sand. Next we have to put the active carbon, as my partner says. This is to stop some smells and those things. Then we put the big rocks. At the end we put the big rocks. It's important to mention to let like 3 centimeters of space to drown full it completely. So that is the first level of the filter. Then our next step is the second level, and it is really important because this one is the most important. This is the one who will make sure that the water is getting really clean. The first layer that we will put again is cotton. In this part of the filter, we will be putting cotton between each layer. For example, here we have like a big layer of cotton, then we have carbon again, then we put another layer of cotton, and after that we put the fine sand, then we put another layer of cotton, and again we put a gross sand, and at last we put a big layer of cotton. It seems to end, but it's important to mention there are some details that cannot we have to take on, and a tip and is to I would recommend you to wash really well this all of these materials. These are like the most important, that this is the like the most relevant thing. If we don't wash really good our materials, this project will not have success. Why? Because imagine if this rock is messed up, all of this mess will go down to our water, and it will not be clean in water. Instead, it will be like getting more dirt. So I would recommend you to have a lot of patience, because these materials are not easy to wash. But as I said, that is like the most important point. That is the clue of all the project, to wash really well all of the materials. So to end the procedure, I will give you a resume. I will let you know another time how to put all of these layers. First we put cotton, then we put small rocks, then we put gross sand, then carbon, and then the big rocks. Later, in the second level, we put another cotton, active carbon, then cotton, fine sand, then we put cotton again, grass sand, and cotton. And how to use it? As I told you, to let you a little space, with the scissors, we can do a hole, and we can put some a tie, and we can tie it up with the other level here, or it depends how they want. If you want, you can put it near a place where they can stand up, and all it depends on your creativity. This project, they, as I told you before, it does not have an specific order. It depends how do you want to do it and your creativity. You must put up your creativity, and that.
As you saw, these materials are easy to use. You can find it everywhere. For example, the rocks and the sand, you can find it in your backyard. You just need to find some cotton, you need to buy it in any store, and found carbon. This is an easy project and it's very useful. As my partner say, you have to consider that you have to watch really well the materials to make sure you get a good filter, that you get a really clean water, and you can use it, for example, with the water from rain. You can filter the water and you can use it for example to wash the dishes or for something else. So it's a very useful technique. Now my partner is going to give the conclusion about this eco filter.
All right, as my partners explain you how to do it, this is the final project, how it should be. So the importance of making an eco filter is apart to be friendly with the environment, it's to take chances about the planet, about the saving ideas of the planet, and that idea could expand to the high schools and schools to teach kids how to do it, and maybe in the future they could be a bigger idea about projects to help communities, because we have to remind that kind of projects as ecofilters, they are very useful for those communities or families who are limited resources in their homes, or for those who live in very rural areas. So they aren't able to get the basic elements as water or electricity. Also, another advantage about the eco filters is that they don't need to use electricity, because you can use it without a battery or any light. Another way I have to recommend you, that the water that you will filter there, it's not for drinking, it's just for domestic use, as washing dishes or cleaning the house, washing the car or something like that. Another recommendation about it is that you can have it in any place. You will need to be inside home, because you can recollect the water outside, but to filter you will need to enter that water and put on this. So that's our conclusions. That is a very easy project, an economic project that any people can do in any age. So thank you for watching, and yeah.